Hey all, it's Matt from Style Factory here, the go-to site for business app reviews. In today's video, I'm going to compare two popular design apps, Canva and Figma, and help you decide which one is right for your needs. Let's start with a look at the key difference between them. Canva and Figma are both browser-based apps that let you design stuff, but they're actually rather different. Canva is aimed at users with minimal or no design experience. It provides a wide range of easy-to-use design features and assets, including templates, royalty-free images, and very user-friendly image editing tools. These can all be used to create a huge variety of visual assets, but typically, Canva users end up using the platform to create marketing material. Think Instagram reels, social media posts, banner ads, presentations, and so on. Figma, on the other hand, is primarily about interface design. It excels in wireframing and prototyping for websites and apps. Additionally, its vector-based design capabilities and real-time collaboration features make it a go-to solution for professional app designers and developers. So, as you can probably already tell, if you're a marketeer, Canva is usually the better option. And if you want to create mock-ups or prototypes of apps and websites, Figma is going to make a lot more sense for you. That said, the lines between Canva and Figma are becoming a bit blurred. Both platforms now share a range of features that make them competitors in quite a few areas. The key things they have in common are drawing tools, photo editing features, presentation makers, whiteboarding functionality, and web design tools. So, in the rest of this Canva versus Figma comparison, I thought I'll give you my take on how these shared features stack up against each other. Just before I do that, however, I'd just like to point out that if you're interested in using either tool, do check out the video description, where you'll find the latest trials and offers for both. You'll also find links to other useful resources about Canva and other graphic design tools. Okay, let's go through the shared features now. Drawing tools. In Canva, the drawing tools are very straightforward. You simply get a pen, marker, and highlighter, and you use these to draw freehand on your designs. This simplicity is its strength. It makes adding lines, doodles, and other personal touches to your work extremely easy. In Figma, by contrast, digital drawing is taken to a professional level thanks to a suite of tools that facilitate both freehand and technical drawing work. These allow you to draw straight lines, curves, and complex shapes with much more precision than the Canva equivalent. They also let you add, subtract, or manipulate anchor points on your stroke to refine your designs until they are just right. So ultimately, it's a win for Figma here. It gives you much more powerful drawing features than Canva. Photo editing features. Canva and Figma both provide you with features for editing and manipulating photos in various ways. I was a bit surprised, however, to discover that the photo editing tools in Figma are rather basic. They let you adjust settings like exposure, saturation, tint, and contrast, and facilitate basic cropping and resizing, but more complex image edits will need to be done in external software. Canva's image photo editing capabilities are much more extensive. It gives you lots of editing features that you won't find in Figma, including a photo background removal tool, a large range of Instagram-style photo filters, and lots of photo effects. It also includes a really useful AI tool that lets you expand a photo's background. Overall, when it comes to built-in photo editing capabilities, the tool with the better features is definitely Canva. Presentation makers. Both Canva and Figma come with presentation makers that let you design slideshows, add speaker notes, and present your content in a polished manner. Canva has a big edge when it comes to the quantity of presentation templates on offer, however. It gives you access to 20,000 templates, while Figma restricts you to just 300. And Canva's presentation maker is better when it comes to functionality, too. Unlike Figma's, it allows you to add a range of sound effects, claps, drum rolls, etc. to your slides, and it also features a built-in video recording feature for creating narrated presentations. A particularly useful feature of the Presentation Maker is the way it lets you use the Canva smartphone app as a remote control for your presentation. This is perfect for managing your presentation from anywhere in the room. Finally, Canva is better for exporting your slideshow because it lets you natively export to PowerPoint PPTX formats. In Figma, this can't be done without the aid of a plugin. Figma's new Slides feature includes some interesting interactive capabilities that you won't find in Canva, however, like live polls and clickable prototypes. Additionally, it lets users add interactive elements like stamps and annotations. But overall, when it comes to creating and delivering presentations, Canva wins. Whiteboards. Canva and Figma both offer powerful whiteboard tools designed for working on brainstorming sessions, mind maps, and all sorts of different visual collaborative project work. A key difference between both platforms' whiteboard tools is that Canva's whiteboard is embedded within the regular Canva interface, while Figma's whiteboard tool, which goes by the name FigJam, opens in a separate environment. This makes it a bit easier to use than the main version of Figma, because the key whiteboard editing tools are always on view and you don't have to dig through lots of menus to find them. As with presentation templates, Canva has an edge when it comes to the number of ready-made whiteboard templates available. It offers 1,682 templates, while Figma provides just 300. When it comes to zoom functionality, FigJam wins, however, letting you zoom into your presentation up to 800%, while Canva restricts you to a 500% zoom. And FigJam takes collaboration one step further than Canva, providing some additional features designed specifically to enhance team interaction. For instance, it gives you cursor chat functionality that lets you select individual elements on a whiteboard and start a team conversation about them. It also lets users leave voice notes on a whiteboard. This is useful for leaving feedback that might be cumbersome to type out. Overall, both whiteboard tools are extremely good. Canva gets the win when it comes to kicking off your whiteboard sessions with a bigger choice of pre-designed templates, but Figma is stronger when it comes to collaboration features. Web design. Canva's website builder feature is a user-friendly tool that gives you a simple, code-free way to create visually appealing websites. It lets you quickly design and publish websites or landing pages that work well on both desktop and mobile devices. To help you out with this, you're given a choice of over 1,800 customizable website templates. These let you build portfolios, event pages, small business sites, coaching sites, and much else besides. It has to be said that the sites you can build with Canva are very basic, though. The platform doesn't let you create sites with multi-page navigation, and if you're looking for SEO, e-commerce, or data capture features, you'll be disappointed. As for Figma, it gives you a highly specialized environment for drafting, designing, and prototyping complex web and mobile applications. You can design any type of site you like with it, really. But what you'll have to bear in mind is that, out of the box at least, you cannot create a live website with Figma, because it is a tool for designing the layout of websites rather than building and hosting them online. That said, some plugins are available that let you export your Figma designs into popular website builders like Shopify, Wix, and WordPress. Ultimately, if you need a simple website building tool, Canva wins, but if you need to design more complex designs for use elsewhere, Figma is the better option. Summing up. As I mentioned at the start of the video, making the decision between Canva and Figma is quite simple. If you need to design marketing material, it's usually best to go with Canva. And if you need to design prototypes, Figma is the better choice. But when it comes to shared features, it's a win for Canva when it comes to photo editing and presentation making. And Figma wins when it comes to drawing and whiteboards. For web design, Canva is better for creating simple websites that you can actually put live, but Figma lets you design much more sophisticated site designs that can be created in other applications. And that's that, our Canva versus Figma comparison. If you'd like an even deeper dive, do check out the video description, where you'll find a link to our full blog post comparing the two tools. You'll also find links to the latest trials and offers for both. Before you go, please subscribe to our channel and hit the notifications bell. This will give you easy access to all our latest tips on design and marketing. And if you have any queries, just leave them in the comments. We read them all and we'll do our best to help.